Hi everyone, the session you are going to see, we are going to construct a Turing machine that accepts palindrome of a string as an input. Okay, and here the input is made up of the alphabets A and B. Okay, so all the inputs here are of the combination of A and B, and whenever the string given to the system is of palindrome type, then the Turing machine has to go to an accepting state. So that is the condition. Okay, palindrome is a string where we can say a string and its reverse are same. Okay, so I just taken an example like this. Okay, the string is a combination of A and B. Okay, here we say this as a palindrome since the first and last letter are same, and the next letter and the last before letter are same, and this is your end. Okay, so now when you want to reverse this string, what happens? You have A, this B, and this A, and this B, and this A. Okay, a string and its reverse are same. So we are going to take an input over the alphabet A and B. That is, the input is made up of the combination of A and B, and the string here is of a palindrome type. Okay, so now we are going to construct a Turing machine and that accept these kind of input. Whenever these kind of input are given to the system, then the Turing machine has to go to an accepting state. Okay, so here the basic idea of this program, of this solution is, here in the input string the first and last letter will be same, and similarly the next two letter, like when you cancel these two, then the intermediate, like in between string, is also a palindrome type. Okay, so that is the condition that we are going to consider. Likewise, like when you have a string of an arbitrary length, the first half and the second half will be the same. Okay, we can say it as WR problem. Okay, a string with its reverse condition. Okay, so you'll have any random string BB A, and its reverse of the string ABB, then we can say this as a palindrome. Okay, so the first element, second element will be same, and this is also a palindrome. Okay, so this we are going to use a recursive procedure where each and every step we check what is the first element, and we'll go to the last and check what will be the last element. If they both are same, then we are going to make a cancellation, and this procedure is repeated for the entire string. Okay, the remaining input will be taken differently, and for this again we are going to check this element and go till last and check this element. If they are same, okay, we will start the procedure again. Okay, so likewise we have to complete till the last element that is left out in the input. Okay, so as per our procedure, you are going to have a tape. Okay, Turing machine, it has an infinite tape as a memory unit, and as per our condition, we check that we seal this leftmost end, and the tape is splitted into cells, small cells. Each cell is capable of storing one alphabet at a time. Whatever might be the input is written from left to right, and the remaining portion of the tape is, like, whichever it is blank, we are going to use this B or any symbol to represent the blank state. Okay, so whenever a Turing machine process is started, the input, whatever is the input that we consider, the input will be written in the tape from left to right. And we have a read-write head that focuses on the first element, and the transition starts with Q0. Okay, so these are the constraints that we are going to assume while starting a Turing machine. Okay, whenever a Turing machine is started, whatever might be the input string is written the tape from left to right. Okay, and after the input, there will be some blank spaces. So, in order to denote the blank spaces, we are going to use some symbols for representation. Here, I use this capital B that denotes the blank space. And while starting the transition, what is the first element? Whatever is the first element that the input, okay, we are going to, the read-write head focuses on the first element, and the transition starts with this Q0. Okay, so these are all the usual assumptions that is considered while starting a Turing machine. Okay, so for a palindrome of a string, the idea here is we are going to check what is the first element, cancel that, and we have to move right, okay, until we found a blank symbol. Once we found a blank symbol, we have to move left a step and take the next symbol. Okay, so till blank symbol in the sense like till the last we are going to move, and the prior to this blank symbol will be the last element of your input. Consider an input like B, A, B. Okay, and then B, A, B. This B is the first element and this B is the last element. In order to check this last element, we have to move till this blank symbol, and one prior to this will be the last most element. Okay, so the first and last element should be same. So that is what we are going to see. So here you are going to have a state Q naught. Okay, Q naught is the starting stage. While starting the transition starts in Q naught. Okay, and the input focus on the first element. The first element might be either A or B. Okay, so we have to check for both the condition. If the input is A, we have to have one transition. Okay, if the input is B, we should have one another transition. Okay, in both the cases, like we just consider this input, here the input is B. So we can take this path. When the input is B, we have to cancel this B and we have to move till N, and you have to take check whether the prior to this element is also B. Okay, so here we can use the blank symbol for cancellation and we can move right to a new state Q1. Okay, the state is up to the user to decide. It might be either Q1, Q2, Q3 or ABC or 1, 2, 3. Okay, so the user can name the states. Okay, so when the input is B, first we cancel the first element and we have to move till we found the blank symbol. Okay, so we can have, like whenever we have a cancellation, we can have a state change. Now in Q1, we can keep on moving right side. We can keep on moving right side until this blank symbol. Okay, so you may have some A or B in between. In both the cases, A will remain as it is. We just move right. And if the input is B, B remain as it is and we just move right. Okay. So once we found a blank symbol in this tape. Okay. Once we found the blank symbol in the tape, what we have to do? We have to move a step prior to it. Okay. We have to make a right, a left side move and we have to take this input. Okay. So when it is blank, blank will remain as it is. We have to move a step left and to the state Q2. In Q2, if the input is B again, okay, so since the element that we have cancelled first is B, then the last element should also be, okay, so we have to check whether the input here is B. If it is B, one circle is over, okay, we have to cancel this B to blank and we can start the recursively start the procedure, okay. See here, when the input first input is B, we have to cancel that and we can keep on moving right until we found this blank symbol. Once we found a blank symbol over here, we have to make a left side move to take the last element. Okay, if the last element is also B, for this B is cancelled. Okay, so we can cancel this, and again with this remaining input, we again have to consider the same procedure. Okay, so what happened here, we can have a transition to state Q3. Whenever we have a cancellation, have a state change. Okay, so after cancelling B, okay, what happened, we again have to move left to take the next input. Okay, so here once this B is cancelled, first and last element are cancelled. Now again I have to repeat the procedure for remaining set of inputs. So I can move left until I found this blank symbol, okay? Since we have to check this next input as your A, okay? So we have to make a left move, and here till this blank symbol, I have to keep on moving left, okay? So input might be either A or B. In both the cases, I just move left each and every time, and here once I reach this blank symbol, I have to move a step right and take the next input symbol. Okay, and again see here, we have taken only one consideration. If the input starts with B, it takes this B. Okay, if the input starts with A, the same set of procedures will be repeated over here. If the first element is A, then we have to cancel that A to blank and move right to a state still Q3 we have, we can have it as Q4. In Q4, again, like first, if it is A, we cancel this A. I can move till this blank symbol. That cancellation, that movement is done in this Q4 state. In Q4, input might be either A or B. In both the cases, we are just going to keep on moving right. And once we found a blank symbol over here, we have to make a left side move and take the input in the state Q5. Okay, now in Q5, if we have A, since the first element we have cancelled is A, okay, over here, if the first element we have cancelled A, then here also the input should be A. Okay, see, this is a path. When the input is B, the element in the last should also be B. If the first element is A, then the last element should also be A. Okay, so here, this A will be cancelled to blank and we are going to move left. Okay, in both the category, the first and last element will be cancelled, and again we have to come back till this blank symbol, and again we have to make a right side move to take the next input. Okay, so once we start the process again, what we are going to do for this remaining set of input, we are going to cancel this input and we have to take the last element and we have to check both the elements are same or not. Okay, so this process is already done in this Q0 state. So we can direct this Q3 to Q0 when the input is, okay, when we reach this blank symbol in Q3, when we reach the cancelled one, the blank symbol in the Q3, we are going to make a right side move to the state Q0. Okay, and recursively the procedure repeats. Okay, now Q0 on the input as A, it cancel A to blank and it goes to the Q4 state, where in Q4 we just keep on moving right until we found this blank symbol. Once we found a blank symbol, we have to make a left side move, and if the input here is A, we have to cancel this A. So recursively this procedure is repeated for all n number of time. Okay, so now after all this process, we have to define the accepting criteria. Okay, so there are two possible accepting criteria in case of a palindrome of a string. Okay, if the palindrome of a string is of even length, okay, if the string that we consider is of even length, what happened? All the elements will be cancelled mutually. Consider the example like this. First we cancel this B and B, and next we cancel this A and A. So now all the elements will be cancelled off. Okay, so after cancelling this A, cancellation of A, second A takes place in Q5. Okay, so we go to the state Q3. In Q3 we have to keep on moving until a blank symbol to see all the symbols are blank. So we reach Q0. Okay, so in Q0, if the input is again blank, okay, since all the elements are cancelled to blank, the tape will just have the blank symbols. Okay, so in Q0, if the input is blank symbol, it means that all the elements are cancelled off properly. So we are going for an accepting state here. Okay, Q0 is the state where we take the next input and we are going to proceed. If the all the elements are cancelled and only blank symbol is left out in the tape, we are going for this Q accept state. Okay, and similarly, if there is one more acceptance criteria, that is if the input is of odd one. Okay, if the input is of odd length, what happened? Consider a case like ABA. Okay, one A will be cancelled for another A. The first and last element will be cancelled. Now, in the middle element might be either A or B. In both the category, this will be cancelled, but we don't find a pair for it. Okay, so either A or B, this will be cancelled, but the corresponding pair in the state Q5 or Q2 will not be there. Okay, so in that case, we can go for this accepting criteria. Clear? So here in Q5, instead of this A, if we have a blank symbol, we are going for this accepting criteria. Similarly in Q2, instead of this B, if you have a blank symbol, we are going for this accepting criteria. So these are all the possible acceptance criteria. Again, repeat, If it is of even length, if the input given to the palindrome is of even length, then there will not be any middle element, okay? So all the elements are mutually cancelled, and in Q naught we don't have any other, like after cancelling all the elements, state will contain only blank symbols, okay? So in Q naught state, if we have a blank symbol, it means that all the inputs, all the element in the tape are cancelled off, so we are going for an accepting states, okay? And similarly, there is one more possibility. The input might be of odd length. If the input is of odd length, the middle element will be cancelled in the state Q naught, but it doesn't have any path. Like if we can, if the middle element is A, we take this path, we cancel this A to blank, so all the input will be cancelled to blank. The tape will just have the blank symbols. So in Q phi, instead of A, we'll just have this blank symbol. It means that all the inputs are cancelled, all the tape elements are converted to blank symbols, so there is no more left out element, so we go for this accepting state. Okay, so here this is the complete diagram for a palindrome of a string. Whenever the input is given as palindrome, okay, so only the acceptance criteria alone is defined over here. Now we have to define this rejection criteria also, okay? So the possible rejection state over here is, it is given that the input is made up of A and B. So always the input is made up of A and B, and it is a palindrome of a string. The first and last letter is always same, okay? So if we cancel A over here, then in Q5 we should have an A. And similarly, if we cancel a B in this state Q0, then Q2 should have a B. Okay, if we have A, B in this Q5 or A in this Q2, that will be your rejection criteria. Okay, so rejection states are transition of Q5 in Q5. Q5 is the state where the first element is cancelled as A and we are waiting for the last element to be A. So instead of A, we have a B over here, then we have to reject it. And similarly, in Q2 is a state where we have cancelled one B. Now we have to have one more B. This is the first element, then the last element should be B. Instead of B, if we have A over here, then we have to reject it. So these are all the possible rejection state. So with this rejection state, this transition diagram completely defines palindrome of a string of a Turing machine. Thank you.